Since 2012, we've been on a journey, a collaborative, connected journey towards gender equality. The Pacific Women's Program was announced at a time when some of this work was just emerging. 10 years ago, several organizations were just starting up, while some Pacific Island countries were in their early days of developing laws and policies to protect the rights of women and girls. There has been so much progress since, and Pacific Women has been able to facilitate some of that work. But in all cases, we've been connected by the idea that the Pacific must be a place where women and men are equal citizens, where they have equal political, economic, and social opportunities. Pacific Women has been an unprecedented long-term commitment to achieving this vision.
Because of the support of donors and partners, past and present, including Pacific Women, we are now reaping the rewards of all the hard work done, such as the TICC, the Togged Itapuito Counseling Center. We now see how women empowered through the work of Chuuk Women Council and TICC grew to be the strong and capable women. They can speak up about their problems, concerns, and important issues. They are now encouraged and willing to seek counseling without feeling held back by the expectation that women are the silent partners of men. It's not about us fighting men. It's more about breaking the silence regarding violence against women and girls and upholding the human rights, especially those of women.
So we are Women's Fund, and our main mandate is to look for resources, both financial and non-financial resources, to support women's groups and organizations in Fiji. One thing that the pandemic has taught us this year is that we need to be a lot more flexible and a lot more adaptive. So while we are financing different projects and programs, we are also looking at building sustainable movements and learning from our Pacific culture, which truly believes in shared values and sharing resources.
We thank you, Pacific Women, through the support in terms of financial assistance and also our technical, your technical experts that been bring us from a very far journey. Our culture is support the idea of gender equality. So we see this, there's a change coming in. We have now six members of women holding the local level positions in the island communities. Women are more reflected in the community level with the hope that this continue to the national level and in the parliament sitting.
These are just some of the achievements of Pacific Women Partners. Through funding and other support from the program, women have been able to access justice, including survivors of violence, expanded opportunities to earn an income and accumulate assets, taken on leadership roles at the community, provincial, and national level, and shared their ideas as well as learned from each other. We are also seeing initiatives supported by Pacific Women resulting in change across outcomes. For example, projects like the Markets for Change, Port Moresby, a safe city for women and girls, and Safe and Prosperous Districts, which is committed to advancing women's economic empowerment, are now extending beyond empowerment to include leadership, inclusive of infrastructure development, and improved access to services.
Congratulations to partners on the results reached over nearly 10 years to achieve gender equality. Australia highly values our partnerships and the collaboration across the Pacific to achieve gender equality and women's empowerment. We've been pleased to support over 180 initiatives across 14 countries, 1.45 million people to access services, and three Pacific countries now have crisis centres operating where previously there were none. As an Australian woman of Pacific heritage, I have been inspired to work with the strong Pacific women of the advisory board, our grant partners, government, and the support unit. I'm delighted that our partnerships will continue through Pacific Women Lead. Finally, and with great respect, thank you for your partnership and congratulations for the results achieved.
As much as we've achieved, challenges remain. Pacific Women has been an unprecedented long-term commitment. Change, especially change that lasts, takes even longer. That's why supporting work that may be hard to see, such as the work of movements and coalitions, are critical to cementing gains toward gender equality.
One of the many ongoing challenges of women's involvement in decision-making is the deep social and cultural norms that are entrenched in our systems that influence the way people look at women in leadership. We have 6.8% of women occupying our parliamentary seats, which is well below the 25% average on a global scale. This is why it is critical, important for us as Pacific leaders, Pacific women, to continue to contest these perceptions, to continue to talk about it, so that it helps to shift and influence people's perceptions, and to accept that women are legitimate and they are equal and important partners in developing our region.
As the Bible says, we all are equal. Being a leader is not being a bossy person or aggressive. Being a leader is to at least treat everyone equally and also let everybody involved in the activities that we go through.
My vision for the future is for young women and girls to be leaders, and I want to see the government to be more active on the law they set for women, like domestic violence.
I want to see a lot of programs like Equal Playing Field to run through schools, not only schools, but there are some girls who does not attend schools, so throughout communities.
For me, that's the main importance of having a program like the Pacific Girl, is they provide a platform where us girls feel safe and secure to express our voices and our opinions. This ensures that our young ones and our young girls here in the Pacific reach their full potentials with having knowledge of all the social issues that we are currently facing, being empowered to speak, and just being empowered to help make a change in the society that we live in.
You know, as a woman with a disability and having experienced discrimination and also, gaps in terms of decision making, it is crucial that we women, all women, you know, work towards a gender equality world where everyone has a seat at the table and is also part of the decision making, and that these decisions are also sustainable and are realistic for us on the ground. But going forward, I think Pacific Women Lead has to be relevant, and that means, you know, all the issues of each woman in all their diversities has to be taken into account. You know, we have issues of the regional, national gender priorities that we need to work on. We also need to strengthen our women organizations and machineries in the region. And I think it is important that we also must always highlight that gender-based violence is a huge problem for us. It's endemic in our region. But I think most importantly, we also need the men to be with us on this journey. It's only together that we can do so much.
Kudos to the partners of the Pacific Women Program. It is through your courage, strength, and passion that we're one step closer to achieving a truly equal Pacific.